In this video, we're going to take a closer look at a creature called the Froghopper. This is something that you've probably seen many, many times and never really paid attention to. If you look around at this time of year, you'll find this material hanging from certain plants, often on grasses. In this case, it's lavender. This creature really likes lavender, and it looks a bit like saliva or spit. It's actually called cuckoo spit, but it's not spit and it's not from a cuckoo. This is actually an excretion from a creature called the Froghopper. Somewhere inside this froth, there's a small green creature, and it's the larval stage of an insect known as the Froghopper. Now, this creature is a true bug. The word bug is often used to describe anything from spiders to ants and to flies. However, in biology, a bug is a creature that has piercing mouth parts. So in this case, it's a creature that uses a short, stabby mouth part, a bit like this cocktail stick, to stab into the green part of a plant and drain the liquid from inside. We're going to take a closer look and see if we can find this animal. So the froth just offers him some protection, keeps the heat out, keeps predators off because it's got a strange sort of sour taste, and keeps him wet. So if I carefully move this stuff away, we'll find him hiding somewhere around the stem. They're quite hard to see because they're very well camouflaged, and if we look closely, there he goes. So this is the Froghopper. See if I can get them off there. Okay, so this is the larval stage of the Froghopper. As you can see, small jointed body. He's got six legs. Very, very good at climbing and sticking to things. And you can see he's quite soft-bodied and very, very damp on the outside. He doesn't have a hard shell, and what this creature's doing at the moment is finding somewhere to hide. What I'm going to do is pop him back on the plant. As you can see, he's the same colour, very well camouflaged. He'll move up there, and he'll get back into his little hide. Now, as I said earlier on, this stuff isn't from cuckoos, and it's not spit. In America, they call this creature the spittlebug. But in fact, this stuff that I'm touching now isn't spit at all. It's actually liquid that the creature can froth up and excrete from its anus. So what he's doing right now is making some more, fixing his home, and he will hide in there, safe from predators. Unfortunately, later on today, he is going to be going into the frog tank. I'll turn this around so you can see him looking for somewhere to hide. As you can see, he's using his legs to froth up that liquid again, and he will start to produce some more. Froghoppers are amazing creatures. As we've discussed, they feed by draining the liquid from inside plants using their piercing mouthparts. At the moment, this larva is protected by a secretion which he produces himself. It's sticky, it's frothy, it tastes horrible for predators, and it protects him from the heat of the sun. This liquid is what's left over when he's drained the liquid from inside the plant. When he grows, he will pupate and turn into the adult form. The adult form of the Froghopper has a hard outer shell, has wings and can fly, and is able to jump. This is why they're called Froghoppers, not just because of their frog-like shape. They can jump better than any other insect, better than fleas or any of those other creatures that we talk about as being really good at jumping. The Froghopper can jump about 100 times his length. If this was you, that means you'd be able to jump the length of a football field, and that's soccer or American football, in a single jump. In fact, you'd be able to go further than that. And as I said earlier, these creatures are part of the group called true bugs. They're not just bugs as a nickname, They are bugs with piercing mouthparts. Some means of stabbing into their prey, in this case their prey's green plants, and draining liquid from inside. Thanks for watching, and use this information to answer your questions for this week's science. Bye bye for now, and hope to see you all soon.